let's head out to Carlsbad, California, where we talked with Hank Haney about his latest instructional series and advice to help your game.
My big deal is you always have to have a plan. And most people, you know, most people have a tip. Everybody's got a tip, but nobody's got a plan. And I always say a goal without a plan is nothing but a dream. So most people just dream of playing better golf. They dream of getting better golf, but they don't have a plan to get better golf. So I wanted to help people have a plan to take them from where they are to where they want to be, and that's what I do with the Haney Blueprint. Anything you try to change in your swing always has to relate to your ball flight. That's the first place I start. So you have to make sure that whatever advice you're getting, whatever tips you're getting, whatever drills you're trying to do, whatever instruction you're trying to give yourself or instruction you're taking, it has an influence on your particular miss, on your ball flight mistake. Because if you're not fixing that, you're not really fixing anything. You could be working on something that's great information. It might be something you do wrong, but it might not have anything to do with fixing your ball flight mistake. And unfortunately, you can't work on everything. Everybody's got mistakes in their swing. But what's the one or two things you could work on that would help your ball flight mistake? So that's my biggest piece of advice, is just make sure that whatever instruction you're taking, it does relate to your ball flight mistake. And then, you know, obviously, you know, drills are a great way to ingrain a feel. You know, most people don't practice a lot, so any practice that they do would help. But it's got to be specific to your ball flight mistake. That's the number one thing. You know, one of the things that I have people do is I'll have them put two tees down and build themselves a little gate. So I put one tee on the outside of the club, one tee on the inside of the club. And if you can swing the club in between those two tees every time, you're gonna hit somewhere on the club face. The tests show and all the results show 76% of all shots are mishit. People are hitting all over the club face and they don't really even know where they're hitting. So this is a good little drill for people to do, put those two tees down. I tell people that, you know, if you divide your practice into thirds, one third full swing, one third short game, one third putting. And then you divide that into thirds as well. With your full swing, you go one third off the tee, your driver, your tee shots, one third with your fairway shots, and then one third with your wedges. With the short game, you go one third chipping, one third pitching, one third sand. And with putting, you go one third long putts, one third to short putts, and then one third with a makeable range, a 10 to 15 feet. But my favorite advice I've ever given is I tell people, I said, take 100 practice swings a day. You take 100 practice swings a day and your game will improve. You can do some with the iron, you can do some with the wood, you can use full swings, you can use some slow swings. Your balance will improve, your tempo and rhythm will improve, your consistency will improve, your feel of where the golf club will improve. I can't tell you how many people have sent me messages back, said, Hank, I tried your 100 practice swings a day and I played the best round of golf I ever played in my life. And it seems like a lot, but 100 practice swings a day would take somebody about 10 minutes. Take 100 practice swings a day, I guarantee your game will improve.